Hello and welcome to the show. I am here on GTA 5 giving the army a rather peculiar test as they are going to be trying to stop this monster limo. It is, really rather too large for driving around the streets of Los Santos. Nevertheless, I'm going to be trying to use it as a getaway vehicle from the army. I will probably have the strength advantage, certainly against the smaller army vehicles. The barracks may still cause me issues. The bigger concern is, well, maneuverability, pretty much, as, you can see it is not going to fit in the usual hiding places. Off-roading ability, though, should be pretty solid. The collisions on this mod are a tiny bit peculiar. If stuff gets stuck under the back wheels, because of the wheel base of this, it often gets bounced up a long way into the air. So that is something to watch out for. The back end of this can really get bullied about quite a lot. There we go. We got a little bit of a... that is something to be aware of with this vehicle. Now, the monster truck that this is based on, of course, is not particularly slow, so we should have some half-decent straight-line speed. It's not going to be the most amazing. Apparently, we're going this way. I was not intending on going that way, but never mind. The monster limo has decided we are going over this direction. In fact, this could actually... Oh, there's a helicopter there, isn't there? Bugger! Whoa! Uh-oh. Gonna say, if there hadn't been a helicopter, I'd just driven off up into the mountains and hidden. That could have possibly worked. As it is, though, yeah, they are right there. And I don't think, as decent as this will be performance-wise, it's not quite going to be quick enough to shake a helicopter. It's going to be a bit tougher, I think. Yeah, I mean, we can carry good off-road speed in general. Oh no, we got defeated by the dunes. Quickly recover the monster limo. Oh god, it's not quite as easy to bound around out here as it was with the custom Rumpo that I drove last time out. Ooh, carefully does it. Car parks are also not likely to be a viable strategy. This is, I'm pretty sure, too tall to actually fit into the car parks. Although, the good thing, can bounce across the barriers, no problem. Haha, I confused the helicopters as well. They got caught up behind the electrical pylons. Right, straight line speed, 86 miles an hour. Around there, apparently we're now losing a bit. Car, I need more speed. It's around the 80 mile an hour mark. It's not the quickest, but it's equally not the slowest, and it will get up to 80 miles an hour relatively quickly. Please cause an accident for yourself over there. No, not quite. I forgot about the rear wheel steer. Checking to see there's a helicopter, if I could possibly go and dive off road and hide somewhere. We are clear of helicopters, but the bigger problem is that, got to try and get clear of these guys, and I have got to be aware of the rear wheel steering. I might go through something and think I'm clear, and then if I steer the wrong direction, I can get my wheel caught on a army vehicle. So that is something to be wary of. However, we have actually found ourselves in a lovely little quiet place. We're going to dive off-road up here. Now, this is not quite as much off-road as I would like, unfortunately, because army vehicles will spawn on this bit of, well, kind of road, this path, if you will. They haven't yet, though. Ooh, this is looking quite promising, actually. If we can bound our way, now this is where we're going to have to pray that we get lucky, okay? Pray that the monster limo gets lucky, because if we can bound our way over here without an army vehicle spawning in and seeing us, ooh, we might be looking pretty damn good here. I cannot believe this, as we're going to fire the monster limo. Aha, what if we can get underneath that sort of archway over there? That is where we're going to head towards. There are no roads around. The biggest concern is going to be helicopters. There is one behind us, but there's a fair way behind us. Let's try and get ourselves... Oh, don't roll. Don't flounder about on the beach. We're having small issues navigating our way through all of these rocks. This is looking pretty good, actually. Let's just not sink the monster limo. I would go underneath the rock arch, but it is a little bit of a dodgy way to get there. The only helicopter that was around buggered off. And we have done it! Holy crap, in about 3 minutes is all it took for a monster limo to get away. Using the acceleration, using the off-road ability of this, it did the trick. I don't know what happened to the helicopters. Obviously, I managed to confuse the helicopters enough, and they never quite got themselves back into a good position to come and find me again, because some bounding around off-road has been more than enough. That is actually a surprise. I was not expecting the Monster Limo to quite get away that quickly, but it has done it. The Monster Limo has evaded the army. We're going to climb our way back onto the motorway. Is there going to be a Prius around for me to destroy? No, there isn't. Disappointing. Disappointing indeed. But yes, the Monster Limo can indeed get away from the army. Instead, we're not going to have a Prius, so we're going to... No, we're going to be defeated by a Jeep. I was going to roll over the camper van. I didn't time it right. Look down, right? You shall feel the wrath of the monster, or we'll just bounce off you. Okay. I guess it needs a tougher challenge then. Well, that means that the Monster Limo is going to take on the dangerous road. Now, from that last attempt, we know this has got more than enough off-roading ability. However, that's not the only thing it needs to survive the dangerous road. Strength is going to be put to the test, and while it's likely to be a strong vehicle, this one, things like a leaky fuel tank has sunk many a vehicle's attempts. I don't know how tough this one is in terms of shooting the fuel tank, if it's an easy target for the police helicopters to hit, or whether they are going to spend a long time. Probably won't get the fuel tank, to be honest, as that's likely to be at the back of the vehicle and they're, well, trying to shoot at the driver. I also may have overestimated his off-roading abilities at climbing up that mountain. I didn't really give it enough of a running start. I thought I could just go for it. I think the diffs may not actually be helping too much with this. I think a lot of the time one of the wheels is in the air and it's kind of just spinning the wheels about. Oh, bushes are being a nightmare. Okay, maybe not. Let's climb over that mountain. Let's go back down to a more normal route. Taking a couple of bullets. I don't think bullets are a massive concern with this one. This is where we are going to have issues, I think. Oh. Slaloming, if the army don't kind of commit themselves enough, if they don't commit themselves to blocking me, I have a real tough time slaloming out of the way. And that is full commitment from the Crusader there. And that is another actual concern that, well, it's a very large target, this one. It is easy for the army vehicles to come and give it a good whack as they are driving through. I'm trying to get myself back up here simply because I can. We've got plenty of off-roading ability and plenty of climbing across the fences ability. The barracks can kind of, but they tend to get stuck probably 6 or 7 times out of 10. So, yeah, we'll use that whenever I can. And we may as well spend our time off-roading, bouncing towards the dangerous road. Yeah, when I drove the Rumpo through here, they must have changed these gates because they never used to snap off. I've been screwed over a couple of times, actually, by them gates not snapping off. So, yeah, they are... It must have been changed in a update at some point. But, yeah, now they do snap off. The front of this, unfortunately, does just catch. I'm not sure if it's the... It can't be the front bumper. I don't know what it is. Something at the front of this does catch on the floor when we're bounding around off-roading, which is a little bit of a shame. It kind of spoils the flow, if you like, when trying to cross this section. Oh, crap, we're going to end up in the back of a truck. Ooh, no, we're fine. Hello, don't mind me. I'm going through. We're going to use the buggy as a bit of a bounce pad. Still good. The amount of bullets. I love the amount of bullets that have gone on the front third of this. Nothing on the back. The back is completely clean. And front third. Oh, they're getting some good shots on the side there. Oh, crap. Don't spin the camera around. I was admiring bullet holes. Forgot to look for rocks ahead of me on this route. Yeah, I don't have the speed off-road to shake the helicopters, unfortunately, which means we are going to take a fair whack. Oh, damage-wise. But at the start, that's mostly aimed towards the driver. And it is holding up well enough. They're not quite good enough shooting to get Michael through the windows and so on. We'll stick up on this bit. The army are not really posing too much of a threat at the moment. My big fear with, well, the dangerous road is simply the size of this. And we saw how easy it was for the Crusader to pretty much T-bone us. Now, where the Crusader T-boned us wasn't a problem. There was more than enough space to spin around and carry back on again. But down the dangerous road, you're not going to have that. Now, T-boning is unlikely. The road isn't particularly wide, but being pushed around by the army vehicles is very likely. And if they can get their vehicles alongside me or that they can turn into me, they are likely to cause chaos, especially if they get their vehicles like that. If they can get their vehicles caught under my rear wheel, that is when I am in a fair bit of trouble. Whee! It just pings itself sideways. Yes, well done, Barracks. You have made the most effective of roadblocks there. It's actually quite a weird thing to drive. The handling's quite peculiar. Okay, we got away with that one. Being four-wheel steer, but being such a long wheelbase. We're going to bounce away one way and the other, and then we're going to spin, so we're going to go off-roading. That's okay. Don't get it beached. Yeah, it is a little bit peculiar thing to drive. Having four-wheel steering with the wheels so far apart makes it... It's really hard to describe. It's kind of like it's oversteery, but not all at the same time. That was a little bit deeper. Well, sounds a bit deeper than I was expecting. I do know how deep that is. I was kind of expecting to get through it a bit quicker. It's a little bit nerve-wracking for the Monster Limo, but we have made it nevertheless. Right, crash our way on to the path once more. Please don't let there be a Barracks on this bridge. I mean, I can deal with Crusaders. I can push them out of the way like so, although I've got my wheel caught ever so slightly on the bridge support. Ooh, something got very broken underneath it. What went on there? I don't know. Have I taken some damage to my wheels? I'm not sure. The handling went very peculiar. Okay, I think we're free. I don't know what it was. Something got caught under the back of the truck and got very angry at me. Now we're back to normal, or as normal a handling as you're going to get with this vehicle. Look out, hiker! Sorry, I might have avoided them. I don't know. Oh, this is going to be a problem. Excuse me, Barracks. Barracks, that's not fair. You can't double team me like that. Oh, you've left a nice gap, though. Quick! Monster Limo, go! No! They've found the springboard button! Not good. Oh dear, this is going to be a... Oh no, they've stopped. They could have made a real nuisance of themselves. I say they could have made a real nuisance of themselves. They could have ended me there and then, but they didn't, so yay for that. Right, now where am I? This is not quite where I was planning on going. Now they have actually started to take a couple of shots at Michael. Well, this is a new route. Okay, can we get back on the dangerous road? My plan is if we can climb up here... Come on, keep foot down. Come on, Monster Limo. We can do this. Oh, there's a helicopter crashing into the ground above me. Thank you for that. That's just what we needed. Now, can we drop back down onto the dangerous road? This is risky as... I think this is about the riskiest thing I've ever done versus the army. Hey, guys. I mean, I don't really mind too much about these vehicles being here. It's the barracks that are the problem. Ugh. Squash, squash, squash. Go, go, go. Oh, look at that. Absolutely perfect. I could not have done that better if I had wanted to. Fantastic. We're back on the dangerous road. There is a small bit of fire. Small bits of fire. That's not good. Not good. We have got further, though, than some vehicle. Got further than the Rumpo Custom did. So, I think it might be too much bullets. Too many bullets going into the Monster Limo, but that was one hell of an attempt from the vehicle. Well, it is without a doubt causing a spectacle, this vehicle. However, it couldn't complete the dangerous road. I am going to try and drive it up Mount Chiliad, though. I think it might be a little bit too susceptible to helicopter gunfire. I did notice that the fire was going on in kind of the middle of the truck, so perhaps them shooting at the driver is still... to be fair, I don't actually know if it makes any difference where they shoot on the vehicle. It's likely to catch fire and so on. Oh dear! The wildlife, of course, some issues! The wildlife may have caused the biggest issues we've had for the Monster Limo in some respect, as opposed to, you know, the truck's getting caught underneath it. No, the wildlife. The collisions are a little bit odd on it, but still perfectly dry. I've driven a hell of a lot worse vehicles with wonky collisions. Still perfectly drivable, still good fun. Yeah, very, very spectacular this. Perhaps the helicopters, I think, are going to be the most dangerous thing in this kind of a challenge. By climbing Chiliad or the dangerous road, you often leave yourself exposed to the gunfire, and this is simply not fast enough when we do get on a straight bit to shake a helicopter. It can't really get away. We've given birth to a mess. Well, now things are getting a little bit peculiar. It had done so well up until now without collisions going too wonky, and well, yeah. Okay, so we've got to be careful. If stuff kind of rams the back of our vehicle, that's when physics gets a little bit angry, but never mind. We're in oncoming traffic, which is probably not the safest. Whoa! Barracks is pushing a messer towards us. Oh, that's not going to go well. Tip the truck. There we go. We need a bit more ride height at the front. I don't know what it is that catches on. It could be that sort of of the axle. It could be that it's catching on the ground as we're trying to bounce across stuff at speed. That would kind of explain that. I would not walk through that gap, army guy. You see this thing coming towards you, you do not go and stand in front of it. And that is not a wise thing to be doing. Where are these guys going to go? Ooh, I was really expecting him to take out my rear and cause all sorts of issues for the monster limo, but that was not the case. Right, Chilliad, here we go. Can I make it to the top? I'll be honest, I think we're going to struggle. I think we are going to really struggle climbing up here. We have the power to do it, I think, and the off-road ability to do it, but we're only really going to be able to do it on the normal road. Unlike some of the supercars and some of the crazy vehicles that I have driven up here that have had more than enough power to take just about any route they want up Chilliad, this doesn't really. Oh, the cargo bob's going to try and pick us up, I think. So this we're going to have to pretty much stick on the path, and that means, well, army vehicles coming towards our face. Although I got on the brakes at just the right time there. If I can keep doing that and confusing the barracks, maybe we will make it. Oh, well saved. Well, I say well saved. We crashed it off a rock, but it did do the trick, stopping the messer from going over. This is going to hurt, I suspect. Oh, okay. Well, we can, if we get them, if they hit us dead on, I think we can probably ride the hit, but we can only recover this because it was at a wide point on the course. Further up won't be so kind. Oh, no, Crusader, don't spin us now. Messer! Oh, again with the front-on collisions, but Messer is tumbling and I am not. We are still good to go. Go on, barracks. Oh, they're doing a better job, I think, of keeping these vehicles on the road. Oh, we got squished against a rock. Again, though, we're down the same point. We may be able to recover it. There we go. Yes, we have. We're going to recover it just in time for the next lot of army vehicles to... Nope. Okay, they've avoided us. I was going to say, we're going to be stuck in a perpetual cycle of not going anywhere up Chilliad. Where are we going to go to dodge this one? To the left? Yes, just far enough to the left to get away. I'm going to hide behind this rock. Yeah, you guys can do that. That's fine. That's absolutely fine by me. Oh, I would love to have more power. I would love to have a lot more power here. Yes, Messer, push the barracks. Uh-oh, we might be about to be in trouble. Actually, no, that's okay. I think we can recover from here. We can recover. We can get going again. Yeah, we're going to stick to the left, though, because... Oh, no, that's going to hurt big time. Oh, tried to kill my momentum so we didn't get pushed as far down that mountain. It has, again, is working enough in that I'm still clinging on to life here. I think the helicopters are going to finish us off before we ever get to the top of Chilliad, but there we go. To be fair, the last explosion could have been a leaking fuel tank that I can't actually get the camera to go low enough to see at this stage. Could have been a leaky fuel tank and my exhaust set fire to it. Oh, no. Bad things are about to happen to the monster limo. No. Oh, we saved it. Holy crap. I thought we were going to go all the way to the bottom. I think that may be the greatest save of all time we have had on the Chilliad climbs. Come on. Oh, no, it's too steep now. Are we having issues? Come on. Wait, hold on. Stop. I can't get it stopped. It's just that fraction too steep to get the monster limo going again. So let's get back on the path. We're still not out of this yet. We are still not out of this. That could finish us off if he can get turned. He can't. Right. Oh, no, the helicopters are going to be doing so much damage, but we're moving once more. That's going to be a big explosion any minute now. No? Disappointing. Look at it go. I've got to look at the road now. I'd love to watch it tumble all the way down because that might actually make it the whole way down. Hello, helicopters. Just hovering there. Don't mind me. Barracks, please don't hit. Can't avoid that. Oh, now we're going to be the one tumbling down Chilliad or not. And we're stopped. Okay, fine. You know what? Screw you all. I'm going in reverse up Chilliad. Not sure this is a good idea. We don't seem to have... actually, tell a lie. We've got going relatively well. You know what? Bugger it. We're going for the reversing tactic. If you could... No. Ah, that is a problem I did not foresee. I forgot how easy it was to tip the rear of this and get it unhappy. Once more, we've saved it from tumbling a mile down Chilliad. I don't know how this thing is still going. It is stubbornly clinging on to Mount Chilliad. I think the engine is going to give up. Oh, that was a big cough. Whee! Bye-bye, Crusader. That was a big cough from the engine. We are probably not going to last much longer, so let's try and get as far as we can. Let's keep the momentum going. Try and dodge the barracks. I couldn't do it. Oh, I think the engine is going to give up before I can get it. Whee! I don't know what we're doing here. Oh, that's a stunt. Oh, this thing has got to win best stunts versus the army for sure. Well, maybe this behind the army with some of their shenanigans that they've done in this. That was another incredible, incredible ballet display from the monster limo, and we're still clinging on. No, don't cough there, engine. Don't cough. Don't give up. We can do it. We are so close. We are so close to the top of Mount Chiliad now. Oh, it's gonna. I think we're gonna have a no. Can't swerve then, that's the problem. They're not committing soon enough for me to do anything about it. No, roll over, roll over, brakes, be good, be good. Oh, they are quite good, actually. We are. No, we're dead. We're gone for. We were so close to getting to the top of Mount Chiliad. There's a fire on the roof of the monster limo. I did so well. It clung on to the mountain. The couple of the saves where it really should have tumbled the whole way down. It's somehow stayed on the mountain, but in the end, just the damage from the helicopters was too much. Just so many bullets were being fired into the vehicle that it just couldn't quite keep going. That is made for one hell of a spectacle. Very good fun to mess around with the monster limo. As ever, I will put links to all the mods that I've used in the description so you can download them, have a go with them yourself. But that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, goodbye.